My name is Scott Davis, and I'm the lead for the AC charging experiment. We're going to be using a Freon 22 system to look at the effect of charge levels and coefficient of performance. So we're going to start off here with the condenser. So from 1 to 2, you start off a high pressure and a high temperature in because it's coming out of the compressor. And the reason that happens, we do that so that it can give off heat to the external. And then as it comes out, with that heat being given off, come out with a moderate pressure and a moderate temperature. And then the next part, you have the expansion. In this case, it's through a capillary tube, sometimes an expansion valve, but you're dropping temperature and pressure across that valve. And we're going to treat it like it's ideal for this experiment, but it's actually not an ideal process due to the Joule-Thompson effect. And then the next part of the process is 3 to 4. You have evaporation, low pressure, low temperature in, low pressure, moderate temperature out. You're taking heat, you're absorbing that heat from the internal. And then last part of the cycle is the compression cycle. You're putting work in and you're bringing that lower pressure and lower temperature up to a high pressure and high temperature so that you can reject more heat. So that was just a quick review of a refrigeration cycle. So a coefficient of performance, what you care about is how much heat you're able to transfer over the work in. That's actually upside down here. But the way that we're gonna measure that, we have pressure transducers. You can see the red circles here, 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 and here. Inlets and outlets of all of the equipment. And we're going to take that temperature and pressure and correlate it to entropies. But one of the issues we're going to run into, you can see here, if you have a pressure and a temperature but you're within the vapor dome, then you actually can't correlate that to a certain enthalpy. So we're going to assume that we have either supersaturated or superheated vapors in the mix. And then the work in is just from the compressor. So our procedure, we're going to run a few different times through. We're going to start off with fully charged. So we're going to charge the Freon unit as much as we can. And then we're going to run through and steadily drop down to about 14 pounds. And we're going to record that data through each of those cycles. And we're also going to use a psychrometer and anemometer to perform an evaluation on the evaporator itself. And these are our TS and pH. This was actually, I treated it like a TH, so this should be a flat line across here. This is what it would be if it was a TH. So the TS diagram, again, you can see from 4 to 1, you've got your compressor. 1 to 2, you have your condenser. 2 to 3, you have your expansion valve or capillary tubes. And 3 to 4, you have the evaporator. Our expected results, like I said, we're going to be treating it like it's an ideal process. So it's going to be TL over TH minus TL, the temperature difference. But real world, it's actually not that. So we're going to correlate the enthalpies. Again, here, this is upside down. But this is actually the correct equation. So H4 minus H3 over H1 minus H4. So we can't actually get that number until we run the experiment. The TL over TH minus TL is an ideal result. It's a Carnot efficiency. And these are my references.